Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know I just posted the March Amazon Roundup as my last video, but since I posted that so late and today is May 1st, it's time for the April Roundup. April, I had some good stuff, so I'm excited to share it here on YouTube. Honestly, I can barely remember what I shared, so I'm gonna have to pull up my own Instagram and look at what videos I posted. Plus, it's kind of blurring together with what I shared in March versus April, so I'm definitely going to be revisiting my posts. If you're new here, my name is Kaale, and I share a lot of Amazon finds. My handle across all socials is HeySweetK. I'm gonna have everything that I share in today's video linked below in the description. Also, before I get started on the Amazon finds, I did share this t-shirt in one of my like pack with me type videos and I got a bunch of questions on it. So I'm gonna leave the link below. It was from Nordstrom. I think it was pretty affordable. I'm just checking now and it was $24. It's fully stocked in all sizes as of today. Free shipping and returns. It's one of my favorite t-shirts with all the little bows on it. I love the coquette style going right now. I'm wearing extra small. That's my regular size and it fits great. Not too tight, not cropped either. I really like the sleeve length on it. That's a big thing for me with t-shirts. And I also like how the sleeve isn't too tight. Okay, let's get started on the Amazon finds. All right, I just looked and the very first video that I posted for the month of April, on April 1st actually, was my new pink tea kettle. I actually need to go grab it from the kitchen so I can show it to you. Okay, I'm back with the kettle and here she is. This kettle is just stunning. I can't recommend it enough. I love it so much. The pink color is just exactly what I love. The little gem on the top here gets me every time. This is hand painted, so it is a little bit more of an investment as far as tea kettles. I think it's somewhere over $100, so it's not crazy, but it's definitely a little more expensive than you would typically spend on a tea kettle. But I'm telling you, worth every penny. Every single time I pass by this in the kitchen, it just makes me so happy. It is so pretty. This isn't just decorative, it actually does work like a regular kettle. It is just outstanding quality. I have never seen a tea kettle that I liked more than this one. I just love everything about it. Even if you don't drink tea that much, I'm telling you, I know it sounds kind of silly to buy a tea kettle for decoration, but you should do it. It instantly elevates your kitchen. You get so many compliments on it. Anytime someone comes over, they immediately notice the kettle. It is a showstopper, and this pink color is what dreams are made of. I remember I got a mailer from Mackenzie Childs when they announced their Rosy Check collection, and I about died because I have a bunch of Mackenzie stuff in the black and white. I have the Sterling Check, like the gray and white canisters, which I love, but this color could not be more perfect. This is exactly what I wanted. But my first video was on an unboxing of this kettle because I did order it from Amazon. It's still on Prime in both sizes. So this size is the 2-quart and I do have the 3-quart. I'll show it to you so you can see the difference. So 2-quart versus 3-quart, and you can see that the 3-quart is quite a bit larger. This thing is actually huge. And while I do love the bigger one, and we did use this quite a bit, when you fill it up with water, it is very heavy. I would almost recommend the 2-quart over the 3-quart. I do love the size of this one though. I think it looks really nice on the stovetop. However, in terms of function, I think I do prefer the smaller 2-quart just because it's so much easier to handle. Like I said, when it's full of water, it's definitely not as heavy. Especially if you're only gonna make tea for yourself or hot water just for you or a couple of people. But it's just your preference. You can see the sizes once again. This one's a lot bigger. Speaking of handle, I feel like this is blocking my eyes and this looks so silly right now. Speaking of handle, I just love the color of the handle that they picked on the pink one. I'm telling you, this is a 10 out of 10. And also, Mother's Day is coming up. If you need a gift for your mom, you cannot go wrong with this. I actually got my sister one for her birthday last year, but she has the floral one, which is one that she mentioned she liked a while ago. So if you go to the listing on Amazon, I have it linked below. You can see how many different options there are, but I'm partial to the rosy one. The next video I shared was on this mini travel suitcase. This luggage has a nice hard shell on the outside. I actually featured this as a beauty suitcase because it's one of the only ways you can travel with all of your full-size products, unless you toss all of them into some type of duffel bag. Those larger aerosol cans aren't really gonna fit into a typical toiletry bag. I used this to feature full-size hair care products. So on the one side, I did a curling iron, a hairbrush, a headband, just different hair tools that I might need or use on a regular basis while I'm away somewhere. And then it does zip closed here on this side, and on this side I used for a bunch of different aerosol cans like volume spray, dry shampoo, hair detangler, hair mask, heat protectant spray. Now, all of these products are kind of excessive, so if you're on a trip, you might not necessarily need all of them. This is kind of for the person that wants to bring all of them and wants to bring all the full sizes. And then in this section, I put hair accessories like hair ties, scrunchies, things like that. And the other really cool thing about this suitcase is it does have a little luggage strap on the back. So once all of your beauty items are packed, you can just slide it right over your luggage handle. Now, obviously for this one, if you have full size hair care products in here, you cannot bring that on the plane like in a carry-on. So I would say if you're gonna pack full size products, this would be better for like a road trip or staying over at a friend's house, going to a wedding where you're staying overnight somewhere, something like that. If you need to bring it on a plane, it would have to go in your checked bag. I don't know if you could actually check a bag this small, but just keep that in mind if you're gonna be packing full size products in here. I think this is just so fun. It's like a mini hard shell carry-on. Up next are two kitchen finds. First is a cheese grater, or it's not just a cheese grater, actually it's just like a general grater because you can grate so many different things. It's super easy to assemble. It comes with this base that you can suction lock to the counter so it won't move around. And then this is really easy to just install it like that. It comes with these three different attachments, so there's like different shapes you can grate vegetables or cheese. This one's like a fine grater, this one's a thicker one. And all you do is stick it in the base here, then you attach the handle to the end, and voila. And then you can just crank it like this. Oops. Okay, I think I got it. And then you just crank it like this. I promise it's a lot easier than I just made it look. Also, they're really easy to switch out, so you just push this handle down and it comes off like that, and then you just pull it out. All these pieces are dishwasher safe too. If you're somebody who likes to have freshly grated cheese, I know a lot of people don't like to buy like pre-packaged shredded cheese. They like to buy a block and shred it themselves. This is your best bet because you're gonna be able to grate cheese so fast. It's gonna be so fresh. You won't hurt your wrist or your arm standing there for 10 minutes. And also this thing that it comes with is super helpful because you can just put the block of cheese at the top and use this to push it down so you don't have to worry about your fingers getting caught in the blades. Highly recommend this one if you are gonna be shredding a lot of cheese or a lot of vegetables. This is your best bet. And then the other kitchen gadget I shared in that video was kind of like another grater, but this one has 9 functions. And the other cool thing you can see in here, all of the attachments that it comes with, which it does come with quite a few, they fit inside the bowl. The way this works is it has a spot here on the top where you put the different blades, and then you also open it up and you put another blade right here. So it has all different attachments. It has like fine dicing, it has a wavy blade. This is good for like shredding carrots. It has this quarter chopper if you want to chop like an onion in quarters or like half an onion. This one's just a regular dicer. It has this slicer blade. This one is another one for shredding. This one is like a grater attachment for like cloves of garlic. This one's also really cool that I've never seen on another chopper. It's an egg separator. So if you are baking or cooking and you need just a yolk or a white, this separates the two. There are just so many different ways you can prepare so many different foods with this gadget. I'm just looking at the listing so I can make sure I didn't forget anything. You can do waffle fries with the wavy slicer. You can do paper thin sliced cucumbers with a slicer, finely shredded carrots or regular shredded carrots, small dicing, regular dicing, large dicing. I kind of went over those. My personal favorite way to use this, which I did show in the video, is by making a chopped salad directly into the bowl. This actually comes with 2 bowls. It has 1 slotted bowl, so if you want to chop lettuce, put it in here and then rinse it out, you could do that. Or if you have lettuce that's already clean, you can put the lettuce right in here and then chop all your vegetables directly onto the lettuce. That is my favorite way. It was so fun. I gave my mom the salad that I made in the video and she loved it. She kept asking me to make another one. It's just so easy to get all these different vegetables in different shapes and sizes into a salad using this thing. Just like the cheese grater, all the pieces that come with this gadget are dishwasher safe. So it's minimal cleanup. You just swap out the blades, prepare the foods the way you need to, and then stick it all in the dishwasher when you're done. The next video was on two more gadgets, but they were for the office. Okay, this one is like really big, so it's kind of hard for me to share. You'll see in the video, it is a cable organizer. So it's a little bit hard to explain. You have to see it, but all of your loose cables that are like hanging out the back of your desk, or if you have a bunch of cables that are hanging below a TV, you can stick them in here and use this clip. You drag it alongside here like this, and whoops. I hope I didn't just break this. Don't do what I just did. That was really dumb. You use that clip to drag all the cables through the funnel here, and it organizes them into one neat and tidy bundle. So they're not hanging loose and they're all together. This one, I think, sold out like instantly on Amazon when I posted it. So it is also linked to Walmart below, because I know you can buy it there too. It's been really popular. I guess a lot of people need something like this, myself included. The next gadget was a personal air cooler. I shared something like this from this brand last year and you guys really liked it. It's a fan that has different speeds, and this one's really cool because it has these ice packs in the back, and it comes with this little additive that you pour into the water and it turns into this like ice gel. So the ice packs stay cold for a really long time, and then it blows like icy air out. That's how it works. It has adjustable vents right here on the side. Also, it has 7 different LED lights and an option to have no lights if you want to sleep with it during the night and the light bothers you. I shared this one as an office gadget because it's really ideal to use on your desk. If you have an office or a cubicle that gets warm and you just like to have that extra cool air, this is your best friend. It's portable too. It's really lightweight. It's easy to take with you from room to room. Sits really nicely on your desk, doesn't take up a lot of space. It's got a really nice power to it, and it's a great little personal air cooler. Next, we have a pink find. It is a jewelry organizer case, and you could use this for things other than jewelry. I just think it's best for jewelry. I'm pretty sure that's what it's designed for. So it's this little case that comes with all these different soft containers. They're like little pockets. So they all come out like this. There are 6 of them. This is what they look like. They have a transparent cover on the front, and then you just unzip it like this and you open it and you can put your jewelry inside. It's also really soft on the back, and the entire inside is nice and soft, so nothing will get damaged. It's all pretty cushioned. These are so nice to keep like your earrings, bracelets, watch bands. They're all organized so nothing will get tangled. I did put a necklace inside here in the video and it didn't get tangled at all. It was this one that I'm wearing now. It did not get tangled. I don't know about putting multiple necklaces in one, but I put one in the bag and it stayed perfectly fine. It's also great for rings if you're traveling with your real ring or your fake ring and you want to put both in a bag. This just keeps everything nice and secure. It's really soft. It completely zips closed, so all your things will be safe. I just love the pink color. I like this one a lot because it holds a lot of jewelry without taking up too much space. Like, this is not going to take up much room in your suitcase or your travel bag, but it still holds everything. It's also nice if you have larger pins that you wear, or a hair pin. These are 2 pins that I personally have. It's this one. This is more of like a brooch. And then I also have this pin that I got for my hair off Etsy a long time ago. These are 2 that I would really want to keep safe if I was traveling with them, and they would be perfect in those soft bags. I did have a Stanley video, but I'm gonna share that one after. While we're on the subject of travel, this is actually a makeup brush case. So it's a hard shell on the outside. You open it up like this, and it's got its own set of matching makeup brushes. This one's also really fun because it does have an LED mirror here, and this entire mirror rotates. So you could put it like this and use this like as a stand. You could set it up like this and like do your makeup in the mirror, or you could even lay it flat like this if you wanted to prop it up. It completely rotates all the way around. It's also rechargeable, so if you need to give your mirror an extra boost before your trip, or if you've been using it a lot in the car, like I do my makeup in the car a lot, especially if I leave the house early, you just recharge it right here. It's super easy. The brushes are really nice quality too, so it comes with so many different ones. It has, you can see in the video too, but it's got all these smaller ones. They're really, really soft. They're really nice and soft. I think the quality on them is so good. It's got all different kinds, like an angled brush. This one would be really good for foundation, like buffing it in. This is more of like a powder brush. It's got all kinds of eyeshadow brushes, like angled brushes if you want to do eyeliner or maybe your eyebrows. This little brush is perfect. I always need one of these on the go. This thing is really nice to have. That way you don't have to pack all your makeup brushes like I have. And the other day when I was in the car, I have all my brushes like loosely floating in here. From now on, I can just bring this in the car. All my brushes will stay in here and then the rest of my makeup will go in its own makeup bag. This even fits in the bag. I could just take all my other brushes out and put this in here with my makeup. So this is a lot better to travel with than just tossing all your brushes into the bag, especially when they have makeup on them. It gets the whole inside of the bag dirty. Okay, and the last Amazon find I wanted to share for the month of April is this. I bet you can't guess what this is. This I think is kind of funny because it's actually genius. It's for your Stanley, or I think it could work for other tumblers too, but I think it's specifically designed for the Stanley. So this is actually an ice mold, and you see how there are different sizes. So it says first, second, and third. What you do is you fill each one with water and they make a cylindrical shape of ice. And they're designed to fit perfectly in the Stanley. So you put the narrow one at the bottom and then the middle one and the third one goes at the top because it's the widest. That is just so genius. Ice goes inside, and since the center is open, you can pour the liquid into the center of the ice and then it stays extra cold. We all know that Stanleys are famous for staying cold forever, and now this ice is just gonna make that even better, and it's gonna keep the ice cold for so long. I do want to feature this in another video though, because I feel like a lot of people didn't really get what this is. I didn't really demonstrate it that well. I only showed myself using one size, and I really want to show using the whole system, like all the ice together with the Stanley. I feel like that would be really beneficial for people and they could really get an idea of what this does, because the video I shared was on like packing it with fun snacks for an at-home movie. By the way, those snacks that I shared in that video are chef's kiss 5 stars. Actually, I need to go grab them so I can show them to you. Okay, I just ran to the kitchen because you have to know about these. So when I was preparing for this Stanley video, I was trying to think of fun snacks that I could feature in the snack tray. And I got these on Target Drive Up. So the first one, I always have hair stuck in my lip gloss. These are white chocolate filled waffle cones. And you know, this brand, I have liked almost everything that I've tried from them. It's called Favorite Day at Target. So good. These are, oh my gosh. Let me just show you how many are left in the bag. There are 3 left because I've eaten almost the entire bag. Oh my gosh, so good. The white chocolate is like a strawberry flavor. If you're at Target and you see these, whoops. Okay, that's back in there. If you're at Target and you see those, you have to get them. These were new to me, I'd never tried them. It's this edible cookie dough from the same brand. So good, oh my goodness. You have to be really careful with these because when they're small like this, you feel like you can just eat some. Like just keep popping another one in, and then all of a sudden you've eaten a ton of cookie dough. So I try to just have a couple at a time, but these are really fun. All right guys, that is gonna do it for the April Amazon Roundup. Can't believe it's already May. I forgot what month Roundup I just did. That's gonna do it. I hope you enjoyed this Roundup video. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe, leave me a comment. I really love to hear feedback from you guys. As I mentioned in the beginning, everything that I shared in today's video will be linked below in the description. And thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.